Howard, you've been covering the game at such a high level for so many years. You're as dialed in as anybody. So you're probably familiar with the fact that it's a kind of a foregone conclusion in NBA circles that Zion Williamson's going to come save the New York Knicks. Do you think the Pelicans do anything to try and keep Zion? What happens with Lonzo, and what do they do in New Orleans working on their third coach now under 3 years with Zion Williamson?
Spoken like a true New Yorker.
I'm just putting out the sources and the things I hear from sources around the league, because I'm like you, Howard. I'm just a guy who's been around the league a long time, you know?
It's never too early to tie up-and-coming superstars to the Knicks. It's just never too early. Zion, of course, has totally encouraged that by getting all, you know, cutesy and winky with the media about talking about, oh, the Garden. Love playing at the Garden. It's way too soon for this. Like, way, way, way too soon, even by New York media standards for that stuff. I mean, nobody in the history of the NBA since, you know, this current structure was created with max contracts and a rookie deal, and then you get your first max deal after that. No one's ever turned down the max deal that comes after your rookie contract if you're an up-and-coming superstar. And Zion Williamson will not be the first. He's not going to force his way out in the next couple of years. So he's heading into year three. Then there will be a year four that's also on the option, and then year five is when you can start talking about extension and everything. He'll take the extension off of it just like everybody does, and we can talk about Zion Williamson having wandering eyes, you know, sometime in the year 2025, 26. But it's too soon right now. I do think the Pelicans have a clear urgency, as you always do in this league. When you get a guy who is a transcendent, generational kind of player, you have the clock is ticking always. The clock is not ticking as loudly for a guy who's going into year three as it is for a guy going into year six or seven, but the clock is always ticking, and you have an obligation and a burden or responsibility to build out a competitive roster, a playoff caliber team at minimum, as quickly as possible, and selling them on the idea that you know what you're doing and that you've got a direction and that direction is going to give them a chance to contend for titles. And if you don't do that quickly enough and competently enough, we see what the consequences are. And that franchise knows it better than anyone because, and it's not the current administration, it's not even the current ownership, but the New Orleans team, formerly the Hornets, now the Pelicans, lost Chris Paul once upon a time back in 2011, and then years later lost Anthony Davis. You know, LeBron James, of course, left Cleveland after his first 7 years there because they couldn't break through, and that was a team that had made the finals and won 60 games. So the Pelicans do have a lot of work to do, and they got to do it quickly, and they're clearly moving swiftly. I mean, to their credit, yeah, we could say three coaches in 3 years, but to their credit, they realized the mistake that Stan Van Gundy was not going to work for them, that he was not the right fit, and they moved on as quickly as possible. And they saw that Steven Adams was the wrong investment from a year ago, and they moved on from him as quickly as possible. We'll see what's next.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.